Hey, what's up, Peace? I'm just about to get into it real quick. As we know, yesterday the Detroit Lions win 32-21. Lions rush for about 250 yards, might as well say. It was just the first time we've seen that in probably like 20 years. So when I was about maybe 5 years old, I can say that, I watched There Goes Mavi video earlier, and he was basically just breaking down Romeo Aguirre, his background and scenario, and how he came to be in the NFL, and how somebody like him could ever been undrafted. And I hinted this before, and I said, what if this is how they built their team? A real good defense night. Maybe just one day, maybe by next year or something, let's say they don't draft the way we think they're going to draft. They don't go for the players we think they're going to go for. What if they go and find these gems out of late rounds or, get key players to help out on the defense, that guys that were like, late round picks the other guys that weren't as popular on the team, man. What if that was just the case? What if you get a lot of guys? What if that was the case? Man, let's take a look at Deshaun Hand. What is he? A fourth round pick guy who's known to be a good run stuffer, athletic freak of nature. This guy has done nothing but get out to the quarter. Well, he's bringing pressure at times. 1 minute he's getting a sack, other minutes maybe he's making tackles. You probably don't hear too much, but he gets high remarks on his PFF grade. Then you look at Romeo Aguirre, who's been in the league for about 3 years, but overall, he's an uprising player despite being undrafted by the Giants, Notre Dame. So when you think about it, what if the Lions don't have to necessarily get the number one player, defensive tackle, or something out the school, out of a certain school? They can get the second guy that probably wasn't nearly as promoted or didn't really get too much draft grade boost to be promoted, like Deshaun Hayes. What if they find a big defensive tackle that can come in and claw the hole? What if they find him like in the fifth round or so, and all of a sudden this guy is just coming in, making tackles against the run, stuffing the run. We're like top 10 against the run all of a sudden. What if they find a guy like that to play next to A'shaun? What if they find those guys that don't get the appreciation next to the big name in college? What if they build their defense based off that? No, it's not impossible. I mean, we think about a Patriots defense scheme that Matt Patricia ran for years over there and has brought to Detroit. What did it consist of? Didn't always have superstars on their defense. They had guys that got the job done, that fit to the scheme. And that's how they keep other teams from scoring. They didn't have to be the number one overall defense to win Super Bowls. They had offense to help out. So, maybe that's the state for the Lions. It's like this. As long as the Lions usually had a good front seven, they were always a competitive team, They have an okay front seven. They get sacks. They get pressure from time to time. We're top five in sacks. But, as against the run, we're very weak. What if the Lions find that gem? Now, I expect them to really get a defensive tackle in the first round next year. But let's say they don't. Let's say they choose to go on the offensive line. Let's say they go, they don't get a defensive tackle until like the second or third round. Don't mean they won't find the proper gym. Let's say it's the third round. Who's to say that that guy won't be the guy that really stuffs the run and really makes a reputation for getting out the run despite being, let's say he was like, again, he was like the number two guy on the team on the defense let's say he comes from Alabama. Let's say he was the number two guy to the top rated player coming out their school this year. What if he was that guy, or just the fourth guy in rotation that probably really was the dark horse of the defense, and everybody else got a chance to make their name based off what he was doing that he didn't get the promotion for? What if he's that guy? This video is for those who can really understand where I'm coming from. you know, what if we can build our defense that way? So many teams stress over trying to get that guy, the promoted guy. When you think about it, despite when it comes to Kerryon Johnson, despite how well this guy played in college, you know, you heard a lot more names over him. You heard Darius Geis. You heard, what's the one Seattle got? Rashad Penny. You heard Saquon, of course. Even as it got later, you heard Ronald Jones and Royce Freeman. We got Kerryon. It was some people happy about it, but it was a lot of people that was unhappy about that pick. But now look at us. He's literally got the most rushing yardage as of right now out of all the rookie running backs. He has the most rushing yards. You got Saquon right there with him. Like, he's a few yards under him. They're going net to net. Some people think Saquon eclipsed him, and maybe Saquon might. He might eclipse Kerryon, possibly, you know, at the end of the year. But who's to say Kerryon still won't have technically a better season overall? Kerryon might be the only one that goes to the playoffs or even makes come close to having more success. But that's up to the Lions. I don't think it's necessarily up to the Kerryon. But y'all see my point. Look, the Lions don't have to get the most promoted player out of college. They have to get the guy that fits the scheme, that actually has talent, that knows, that is able to be coached to the level of the scheme. The system works. That's been proven. The system works. The Lions just have to get more young talent out the draft, preferably in the first round when it comes to a defensive tackle. But if they don't, I won't hate it. I mean, he's proven a lot that he can find talent off the waiver wire and trading 7-round picks to get guys who were considered busts, and now they're playing good due to the scheme. So I trust that he'll be able to find us a guy in the 3rd round, 4th round, if he gets 2 defensive tackles in the draft, to come in there in that middle and stop teams from running on us. You know what I'm saying? And so I'm not really that concerned right now. This is just a little video I wanted to make out. You know, I just felt like discussing that, getting that off my chest. Thank you to everybody. If you enjoyed this video, please like, comment, subscribe. Really would appreciate that. To all those in DV, man, I appreciate you for watching this video. And to all of One Pride, I'll hit y'all later. Signing out. Home. Peace.